Hey there, YouTubers, and I say YouTubers, but to me a tuber is just anyone who's sending video content, audio video. It's kind of like a podcaster, a tuber. It's very generic, but then there's YouTube, and in history time, I'm just uploading to YouTube all this time, so YouTube will work. Now, what this little video is going to be about is kind of a little bit of a rant. I'm taking advantage, in a good way, I hope, of the travails of living in a big old house built in 1905 and ancient iron pipes. You can see this one has totally burst open, and this is my kitchen drain pipe. So all my kitchen detritus is coming down in the basement in this picture, and we're like these geeks, kind of software types. It's like Silicon Valley around here trying to fix this. Maybe with putty, right? Epoxy putty, that kind of stuff. But it's really too big. There's nobody on YouTube repairing anything quite that big. But we'll see. We've made some progress. So that's happening. But in the process of doing that, I let my new iPhone, which is not like an iPhone 13, you know, these new iPhones. It's an iPhone 6. Here it is, actually, from my daughter. And she's advocated for years that I should get on it. But I've been using this Android, right? And finally, I left the Android face up in the rain, even not a major rain, for a little too long. So I basically killed my Android, finally. It was on the way out anyway. And see, these are like first world problems. You should watch after this Weird Al's first world problems video. Anyway, down there in the sewer kitchen area, in the basement that is, I let the phone be a flashlight, and then it fell face down in that duty. And this is where I keep the Raspberry Pi, by the way, which I think still works. Amazingly, not all of these electronics were destroyed. Anyway, the phone fell face down in a puddle, and so I wrecked my iPhone. It wouldn't come on. I mean, it's gotten to be a lot more usable, so maybe I've lucked out here. But you can imagine just, you know, in one day finding out about this giant hole in my basement and the iPhone dying thanks to my stupidity, right? Killing another phone. And I was just really grooving on it. I love this experience. Cheering me up, this magnifying glass came as a gift, and Popko's book. So, from the publisher, the two together made a great photo shoot of my gratitude and my life in general. I couldn't ask for a better life. So, right, I'm not complaining about my life, but I do feel the roller coaster, the up and down. And the rant is this old house that we're in, right? It's like when I was growing up, because I'm a Bucky devotee, I was always thinking maybe, just maybe, we'll get to live in a futuristic house. But we kind of saw how that whole vision got nixed, right? If we were going to have that industry, the industry missed. Let's try to get to those pictures in a coordinated way. I'm going to end with this album. For those who are unfamiliar, this channel is largely devoted to why don't we have synergetics in high school, right? That would be a question. And then I show how it would look, what we would do, and I actually just teach high school using synergetics as raw material. But not just synergetics. I go into all of American history, especially the transcendentalists. We're talking Emerson, Thoreau, and drawing a straight line, and then reading Rorty's book, Achieving Our Country, which is a small little book, and I just discovered it in the last year or so during the COVID plague, and I highly recommend it. Why? Because it's about being left, which has a lot in common with being right in certain ways. In certain other ways it doesn't, but without all the Marxism. Because you can draw a direct line even to German idealism through Harvard and through the Transcendentalists of Boston. Without really going through that, what I'll say is a Malthusian detour, because in the Bucky world here, we think that pitting workers versus owners or whatever, it's both if you think the owner should win or you think the worker should win. Either way, it's a more with less. It's a, not a more with less. It's a competition for extremely scarce resources, right? And that we can't sustain our population, and that we're in a big panic, and there's a great tragedy afoot. And there are many great tragedies afoot, but how many are induced? How many do we self-inflict? And that's kind of where we, this is, by the way, the first time the web hosted the Buckminster Fuller Institute. Like, the web was a new thing. And so I'm an old guy now. And so way back in the 90s, this was like BFI.org in its first iteration. And I talk about this on the Trim Tab Book Club. And then on Medium, a reminiscing webmaster, I tie together my experience as the first BFI webmaster with being clerk of IT, that's information technology, but we just say IT, clerk of IT, co-clerk at first, and then ousted because I had some visions that were just troubling, and it just became too much for some people, and so they kind of bent the rules a bit, but that's okay. I got off the hook early. It was still more than a year or two that I worked at that. And so on Medium, I've been spelling it out more if you're into really getting it in writing, right? Because it's very fleeting what we do sometimes just on Facebook or whatever. So I'll end again with the Dymaxion House, which is where we thought we were going. This is before I was born, actually. And it was just, where would we be now? What kind of, think of all the hobby industry, think of all the aftermarket, think of all the economy, all the civilian economy we would have by now if we had allowed ourselves to compete with ourselves, basically to let aerospace and computers converge to do their own version of shelter and not just tents, right? Something more rigid than tents, but still very thin shell aluminum, perhaps. How loud would the rain be? You know, all kinds of questions like that. So might be deafening, right? That might have be what killed the whole idea. The rain was too loud. Who knows, right? But it didn't happen. And rolling forward, we call this the industry mist, which is the application of high tech, meaning maritime heritage, aerospace, thinking like we're colonizing the Earth coming from a Martian mindset. See my video episode 5 with Thinking with Mike Achera, because he draws that out in the interview, how this mind space of going to Mars can in turn affect our vision of ourselves here on Earth. You know, if we're planning to colonize planets, we use our highest tech in those images. And then we come back to Earth and we're all living in shacks or big wooden tents, like I think of this place with ancient iron pipes. You know, we're like really stuck in the past on Earth. Why don't we take some of that visionary going to Mars stuff and apply it to our own planet? And I know Elon Musk has been showing off these box homes and stuff, kind of like mobile homes, but they're stationary. They're not air deliverable. I feel like Bucky already laid the foundation, but we suppress that layer in our archaeology. We actually have layers in history, and some layers suppress other layers. And there's a lot in the Bucky layer that just isn't allowed to percolate up. There's like a lot of, like, I'm using a lot of water metaphors again. This time I'll be on the side of the water bursting the pipes. It's like your pipes are not going to be able to contain all this pressure of unexploited, I know people hate that word, but unappreciated Bucky Fuller stuff. By which, in there, I'm including a whole branch of thought centered on the word design, like Harold Nelson uses it. A very big word, design. Design science. It's kind of like much more taking responsibility, not just a spectator, right? We're not spectators in the universe, we're participants. Something Terry Bristol says a lot. All right, so thanks for listening. Connect all those dots now. You got a small little ball of, you know, a wandering narrative, but you can close that around into a system. Think about pipes. It's mnemonic, right? There's a mnemonic gravity here. Think about pipes. Think about old houses. Think about the industry missed. And think about the high school math that you are currently missing. Are you learning Python? Are you learning Julia? Are you using REPL IT? Are you doing any of this? Right? Are you being allowed into your future? Or are you being held back? That's the question to ask yourself. And are you even being made to pay for the privilege of being held back? That's another question to ask yourself. Thank you. So I'll put some links to some of these writings in the description if you want to take it in more by text. And we'll talk again. Talk to you soon.